Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Saab press conference. I'm happy, of course, to see such a big crowd visiting us. I guess there is something special about Saab, as an example. Last Tuesday was a great day for Saab and all of our supporters. That's when we secured our future. This would not have been possible without the tremendous support from dealers, customers, employees, suppliers, and of course all of our people with a soft spot for Saab in their heart. The determination of everybody involved in this transaction is something that we are of course extremely grateful for at Saab. So what actually happened was that during Tuesday of last week, we exited the liquidation. An agreement was signed between General Motors and Spyker Cars for the sale of Saab. And we also made an agreement with the European Investment Bank, as well as the Swedish National Debt Office. This all leading to that we now at Saab Automobile have a new owner, and we have a fully funded business plan. So over the next 100 days, we will refocus our business and restart all of our activities. This will start with the ramp up of our production. We today have extremely low inventories all over the world that is hampering our sales volume. This also includes the start of the manufacturing of the 9-3 convertible in Trollhättan, Sweden, the vehicle that we have moved from Austria back to our facility in Sweden. We will also restart our marketing activities and activities out in the marketplace. This involves, as an example, the launch of the 9-3X in the US market, as well as the launch of the all-new 9-5 that you see here on stand. The early response to the 9-5 has been extremely positive. It is really a car that delivers on all the key Saab characteristics, including progressive design, but also performance through the typical Saab way with low displacement engines, of course turbocharged, utilizing the typical characteristics of our brand. Of course, we offer alternative fuel in our vehicles, and on the gasoline side, we have engines ranging from 1.6 turbo all the way up to 2.8 turbocharged engines. And on the diesel side, we focus our efforts on the 2-liter turbo diesel, delivering exceptional responsible performance. As an example, our 2-liter TID delivers 350 newton meter with only 139 gram of CO2. Additionally, of course, 5-star Euro NCAP is a given when it comes to Saab. And once you get the chance to drive this beautiful car, you will experience that this is a typical driver's car, which is so typical for Saab. During the next 100 days, we will also start the creation of an independent company, carving out our business from the integration with General Motors. And I must say here that General Motors have been very supportive in agreeing with us transitional service agreement that will ensure continuity in our business as we create our own company. However, if we look a little bit midterm then, what are the key focus for Saab going into the future? I'll divide it into talk about the brand, our products, and our operations. Overall, of course, regarding the brand, is to take our heritage into the future. This fantastic brand that creates such emotions and involvement has its soul or its DNA in being innovative, doing things differently. You all know the turbocharging technology, how we design our vehicles, the focus on safety, etc., etc. Our aircraft heritage is also something that goes through the brand in terms of how we design our cars, how we operate with aerodynamics, and of course functionality. And last but not least, our Scandinavian or Swedish origin, where safety, social responsibilities, practicality, and conscious about the environment plays a key role. This will also be the core of our future. On the product side, we at Saab have always suffered from a very narrow product program. Additionally, our long life cycles have created many challenges for us at Saab. Now we're fortunate to correct these issues. The current 9-3 not only offers four body styles, but also have a broad range of powertrains, including probably the best all-wheel drive system in the market. And we have many new cars around the corner, starting, of course, with the 9-5 sedan that we will launch later on this year. This will follow by the 9-5 Sport Combi and in the beginning of next year. And then we will also, in 2011, enter the crossover segment with the 9-4X. This is a segment that is growing in size and importance and will be very important for the Saab customers into the future. We're also in the middle of the development, of course, of a new 9-3 that will be launched during 2012. All of these developments are fully funded as a part of our business plan, together with the activities to keep these vehicles current as we go into the next couple of years.